الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبعد. إن شاء الله تعالى يا إخوان, we continue with our reading from last night and the tremendous work of Imam Abu Dawood al-Sijistani rahimahullah ta'ala, Kitab al-Sunnah, from his Sunan. And we read last night, Ya Ikhwan, Bab Sharh Sunnah, the chapter of the explanation of the creed, a number of narrations from them, the narration of the iftiraq, iftiraq al-Ummah, and the separation of the Ummah, as we discussed last night in some detail. We also read, Ya Ikhwan, from Bab Mujanaba Ahlul Ahwa'i wa Bughduhum, the chapter of avoiding the people of desires, the people of innovation, and hatred of them. And we mentioned a number of narrations in that chapter as well. And we continue now, Ikhwan, with Bab Tarku Sunnah ala Ahlul Ahwa', leaving off the salams, leaving off the salutations to the people of desires. And the Shaykh, he brings, Abu Dawood al-Sijistani, he brings, Ikhwan rahimahullah, in the chapter of the hadith, An Ammar ibn Yasir. An Ammar ibn Yasir. Qala qadimtu ala ahli, wa qad tashaqqaqat yadaya, fakhallaquni bi za'faran, فغدوت على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فسلمت عليه فلم يرد علي وقال اذهب فاغسل هذا عنك. And he mentions, Ikhwan, in this narration, as we said, collected in the Sunan of Abi Dawood, number 4601. Number 4601 from the Sunan of Abi Dawood. The noble companion, Ammar ibn Yasir, he said, I came to my family and my hand was split and it was open and a wound or like this in the hand. And they put on it some saffron. They put on it some saffron. And as we'll hear and read in the explanation, inshallah ta'ala, is that which has a certain color. Saffron, as we know, the color of saffron. And it also has a certain odor, a certain smell to it. So he said, after his family had put the saffron upon the wound, upon the opening in his hand, he said, he then went to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fasalamtu alayhi, and he gave him salams. And he gave salutations to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, falam yurudda alayya. But the Prophet sallallahu did not return the salams. He did not return the salams. وقال اذهب فاغسل هذا عنك, go and wash that off, meaning the saffron. So what had prevented the Prophet ﷺ from returning the salams to the companion? It was the fact that he was wearing the saffron. The fact that he was wearing the saffron. In a moment, Ikhwan, inshallah ta'ala, will look at the explanation of this. Shaykh Ahmed al-Najmi, he says, rahimahullah ta'ala, in the explanation, he says, وَهَذَا كَفَرَعْ لِلْبَابِ قَبْلَهِ. He says, this, Ikhwan, is an offshoot of the previous chapter. What was the previous chapter? What was the chapter we read last night? I just mentioned the title. Ahsant. It is refraining or staying away from the people of desires, leaving off the people of desires and hatred of them. So he says this chapter is like an offshoot of that particular chapter. فَالْبَابُ قَبْلَهُ فِيهِ مُجَانَبَ أَهْلِ الْأَهْوَاءِ. He says because in that previous chapter that we just read last night, is the leaving off of the people of desires. وَمُجَانَبَ أَهْلَهْوَا تَشْمَلْ تَرْكَ السَّلَامِ وَغَيْرُهُ. And included in leaving them off, included in abandoning them, he says what this comprises also, Ikhwan, is abandoning the salams, the salutations to them, and other than this. وَأَرَادَ الْمُؤَلَّفِ فِي هَذَا الْبَابِ أَنْ يُبَيِّنْ أَنَّ تَرْكَ السَّلَامِ عَلَى أَهْلِ الْأَهْوَاءِ من الأمور المشروعة في الإسلام. And he says, Ikhwan, that what the author, yani, intends in this chapter, what he intends by this chapter, is the clarification that abandoning the salams of the people of desires is a legislated matter in the religion of Al-Islam. It is a legislated matter in the religion of Al-Islam. And we read last night, Ikhwan, from Shaykh Ahmed al-Najmi, that which clarifies the wisdom behind this. You mentioned, Ikhwan, we read from him where he said that the people of desires must feel that that which they are upon is batil. The people of desires must feel that that which they are upon is batil, that is falsehood. If you were to treat them, Ikhwan, with all due kindness and all gentleness and all ease and without differentiating between your treatment of them and the people of Sunnah, then what would make them feel, Ikhwan, that that which they are upon is batil? The great scholar, Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala, Ikhwan, he was asked about sitting with the people of innovation, yani taking knowledge from them. And the Shaykh, he clarified, Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala, that we should abandon taking knowledge from the people of innovation, Ikhwan, even in the matters like the recitation of the Quran and the Arabic language. Even learning from them the recitation of the Quran and the Arabic language. Now listen to why Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen said this is hikmah, Ikhwan, and it connects to with the point that we're making here. Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen said that if the people of Sunnah were to go to sit with the people of innovation and to take from them their knowledge of what they have with Arabic language, recitation of Quran, whatever it may be, he said, then you would fool, first of all, you would delude them. You would delude the person who you're going to take knowledge from. Because that person of desires would say, well, the Sunnis come to me. The people of Sunnah come to me and they sit with me. So therefore, what I'm upon must be fine. There must be no problems in my methodology or in my creed or whatever it may be, because the people of Sunnah come to me in numbers and they sit with me. So the Shaykh, he said that you delude that person first and foremost. And then he said also you deceive the common folk. You deceive the people outside. He said because when they see the people of Sunnah going to this individual and sitting with him and taking from him, they can't distinguish between taking, you know, qira'ah, recitation, or the Arabic language, they can't differentiate between that and taking creed or taking methodology from this individual. So your treatment of a people, the way you treat them, and the way you interact with them, has an effect on how they perceive their methodology and how the people perceive their methodology. So therefore, Ikhwan, we see the wisdom, Ikhwan, and the abandonment of these individuals. And from that, as the Shaykh he mentions, from that which is included in that, is the salutations upon them. أورد فيه حديث يحيى بن يعمر عن عمار بن ياسر. And from that, as we mentioned, the narration of عمار بن ياسر that we just read. He came to his family and his hand was split or had an opening like this, and they placed upon it the saffron. And the Shaykh, he said, the saffron, إخوان نوع من الطيب. And as we said, it's a sort of, kind of, it has a fragrance or smell to it. يعني زعفران في رائحة وفي سفرة. And it has in it that color of saffron. It's like an orangish color. I like this. يعني. And it has a certain odor to it. And he says, إخوان, لذلك نهي عن التزعفر للرجال. So therefore the men have been prohibited from wearing saffron. The men have been prohibited from wearing this saffron. ونهى أيضا عن لبس الثياب المزعفرة. And also we have been prohibited from wearing the thiyab, the garments of this color, of this same color. فلما قدم عمار بن ياسر ولعله قدم من الغزو. And Shaykh Ahmed Najmi, he says, رحمه الله, that when عمار بن ياسر came, and perhaps he was coming from a غزو, an expedition, وقد تشققت يداه, and his hand was injured, and he had an injury on it. فعند ذلك خلقه أهله. And as we said, his family placed the saffron upon his hand. فجاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يسلم عليه. So he went to the Prophet ﷺ to give him the salutation, to give him the salam. فلم يرد عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Prophet did not return the salams. وكما جاء في ذلك الرجل الذي جاء للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وعليه خاتم الذهب. And this is similar, Shaykh Ahmed Najmi says, to another narration that a man came to the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم and he was wearing a gold ring. فألقى على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم السلام, and he gave the salam to the Prophet عليه وسلم. فلم يرد عليه, and the Prophet عليه وسلم did not return the salams to him. Again, he came to him wearing a gold ring, and the Prophet عليه وسلم did not return the salams when he gave him the salams. وكذلك أيضا بعد أن ذهب وأخذ خاتما من حديد جاء للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فلم يرد عليه. And it mentions the Quran that he went and took another ring of hadith, of iron. And he came back and gave the salam. The Prophet ﷺ did not return the salam. ثم ذهب أخذ خاتما من فضة وجاء فرد السلام على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فرد عليه. Now, then he went and put on a ring of silver. Finally, he went and put on a ring of silver. And he came back to the Prophet ﷺ, gave him salams. And the Prophet ﷺ, indeed, in this instance, Ikhwan returned the salams. In this instance, he indeed returned the salams. وكذلك الوفد الذين جاءوا إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقد لبسوا الحرير. And then Shaykh Ahmed Najmi brings another instance when a delegation came to see the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and they were wearing garments of silk. And they were wearing garments of silk. وتختموا بالذهب, and they were wearing rings of gold. So garments of silk and rings of gold. So it mentions إخوان فجاءوا فألقى على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم السلام فلم يرد عليهم. So they came and they gave the salutation to the Prophet ﷺ, but he did not return them. They gave the salutation to the Prophet ﷺ, but he did not return them. فذهبوا يسألون أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن ذلك. So they went and they asked the companions about this. Now this, Ikhwan, shows us that when one does not know, what does one do? You go and ask the people of knowledge. You go and you ask the people of knowledge. So they asked the companions, those who walked with the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, those who lived with him and had studied with him and sat at his feet, learning from the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. So they went and asked him about this matter. And the companions, Ikhwan, look what they said to them. اذهبوا فاستبدلوا ثيابا غير هذه الثياب. Go and change those garments. Put on some other clothes. And they took off those silk garments and go put on some other garments. وألقوا خواتم الذهب. And get rid of those gold rings as well. ثم ائتوا فسوف يرد عليكم. And once you do that, you change those garments to other than silk. And you go and you put on, so take off those rings, and then you will see the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will give you the salam. And this, Ikhwan bil Fikum, is from the wisdom of those noble companions. فَذَهَبُوا فَأَلْقَوْا تِلْكَ الثِّيَابِ. So they went, Ikhwan, and they took off those garments. They changed those garments. وَأَخَذُوا غَيْرَهَا. And they put on other than that, from different material. وَأَلْقَوْا تِلْكَ الْخَوَاتِمِ. And he took off those rings. They got rid of those rings that they were wearing. Look at this, Ikhwan. They followed the advice of the companions. They followed the advice of the companions. They were not haughty and arrogant. They said, well, no, we're going to continue to wear these silk garments. We're going to continue to wear these gold rings. La, ya, Ikhwan. They obeyed that which they heard from those noble companions. Who knew better? As it relates to the dressing and the wearing of the jewelry and the likes of this. So it mentions إخوان فجاءوا فسلموا على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فرد عليهم. So it mentions إخوان, they went afterward to give the salams to the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he indeed, إخوان, returned the salams. Look at this, إخوان. So this shows, يعني, in the following, إخوان, of those noble companions, and in listening to that which they instructed them with, then they were received with success. They received with success, and it shows us, إخوان, بريفيكم. But the Prophet ﷺ did not return the salams to them, Ikhwan, because of what they were wearing, which was in opposition to the Kitab and the Sunnah. And what do we mean, Ikhwan, when we say that what they were wearing was in opposition to the Kitab and the Sunnah? What do we mean when we say that? What's the evidence for that? That's my point. That's my question. So you mean the affairs of dress and normal in the dunya, yani that there's permission as long as there's nothing prohibiting it. That's the point you're making. Nam. I'm now, Ahsan, but I'm specifically asking about gold.